Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you for having us. I got your message and I decided to respond.
Amen.
I bless the Lord. I'm encouraged to be here. God is good. Like Pastor Asuma said, I'm Pastor Laura Gedenji. I lead Jesus Celebration Center, Twin Cities.
Amen.
And I'm just delighted to be in the company of brethren.
Amen.
There is something that happens when believers come together.
Amen.
Jesus said that we shall receive power.
Amen.
And when we gather together, we are a community filled with the power of God.
Amen.
And whatever we do, we were looking at the scripture this morning. The Bible says, what you shall agree on, when you agree on to touching one thing, it shall be done. So we thank God. I came with several people. This is my daughter, Sharon Moshai. Who else did I come with? My sister back there. I saw her singing in the worship. And we are just here to be blessed.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God bless you. Then I'm going to record us.
And
first.
Lillian. Right there. I forgot.
Philip has been a great support. Why don't you stand and greet her?
That's my father.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I think I need a microphone. They can hear me. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
My name is Phil Mumanyi. I love the Lord Jesus Christ as my personal Savior. I'm so delighted Pastor Laura is here with us.
Yes.
We used to be in school together at Bethel. But I'm so happy that God is blessing us with a ministry that's so vibrant.
Yes.
And we'll follow it on occasion.
Yes.
You do. So God bless you.
Amen.
We are so delighted that you're all here. All of you. And the desire of my heart is that you're getting blessed. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Philip's wife is Tabitha over there. Amen. And the love of my life. Amen. If it were not for her, I would not be doing what I'm doing now. She gives me the stability that I need as a man to be able to focus. Amen. Amen. Who is here and you are? Is there another person that I need to? Oh! Why am I forgetting you? You are, maybe because you were here in the morning. Pastor Sarah Nyanduru, why don't you stand and greet us? God's words. Want to introduce the friend of this church for the last time. I've been introducing her since Friday. Pastor Catherine has been a friend of this church for a while. She has been here several times and blessed us, and she blessed the youth on Friday. She has been blessing us since Friday night during the general sessions, and we are grateful for this gift that God has given the church. So I want to assure you that we love you and we appreciate your gift. Come again. But for now, I want us to put our hands together and invite the woman of God to come and share God's word. Yay! Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It's an awesome time in the presence of the Lord.
Thank you so much. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Reverend Asuma. We have come to the finality of our conference. And I just want to say the last word to tie what we have been doing.
Amen.
Because this was a victory campaign.
Yes.
And faith comes by hearing and hearing and hearing and hearing the word of God. So we might have to repeat and touch again and try to put the final bolts and knots so that we may run like soldiers in the kingdom of God. Praise the name of the Lord. I am delighted by what God is doing to the youth. I am delighted. Because I know when I was at their stage and who I was and how God delivered me and healed me and saved me. I'm so proud of the youth. Where's Mora? Where's Mora? Not Barrier, the other Mora. Oh my God. I really wanted to pray for her. When I went to the washroom, she said, "You have imparted my life.
Amen.
There's something, things you have spoken have touched my life and have changed my life." I really wanted to pray us to pray for her before we let her go. Because she's so open. Very open. She looks quiet and calm, but she's open. Yeah. And she mentioned things I said that have transformed her life.
Amen.
You remember what I told you yesterday here? Let us not be judgment. People come one way, but they live another way. So we are learning. Dominic, come and give a testimony of your salvation. He was saying the song he was singing, Amazing Grace, today, made more sense.
Yes.
Before he was born again.
Amen.
Dominic, just come and say hi. Give a testimony. This is what we do when we give our lives to Jesus.
Yes.
I'm not sure where to start.
Say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. I usually have something, like I write it down or something, but just a little something. Since Friday, yeah, I've definitely had a lot more to think about, and like it's definitely been different, and I've definitely felt better since I gave my life, and I definitely learned a lot when you taught us on Friday, and it was very helpful for me. And I've been, just this weekend overall, I've been thinking about how I can keep what I'm learning this weekend as I keep on moving forward, and just keeping those things to me and working harder and harder.
Yeah. Oh wow. Let me tell you, that is the joy of every preacher.
Amen.
This preacher, you know, me, I don't have a church. A local where I can say this is my church. But I have the apostolic grace to go and strengthen churches.
Amen.
And so when I enter a place, I don't want to disappoint. I just break to the Holy Spirit and say, God, I want that church to say they were satisfied when Catherine came. I want them to say we were fulfilled.
Amen.
The intention and the purpose of that vision we had was met.
Amen.
Very important.
Yes.
It's key.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
But thank you all for your prayers, because I realize you have really prayed for this meeting. The presence of God has been evident. So we are going to do the final touch. But meanwhile, these books landed today from Kenya.
Amen.
I was waiting for them. Because the other batch, they're all gone. So these ones are actually, like this one, is a revised edition. So what I was selling before was just the raw one. But this one is revised. So when I wrote this book, before I start preaching, because this is my first book, and I'm already doing the third one, and it will be bigger than this, because I'll be talking about the art of hearing God. And I'll be talking about how God speaks in depth and in diversity. So now, on this book, The DNA of Generational Blessing, I've talked about how God has already patented everything you ever needed within you. So, in your bloodline, your biological bloodline, if you look closely, most times we look at the problems in the biological bloodline, But actually, there are things in your pattern, in your bloodline, that are graced by God. And so I've written about the 12 tribes and what Moses and their father Jacob spoke upon them. And that ran in the family all the way to the New Testament. And so those graces is what I've written about here and how to discern the blessing of the family in your life. So I don't mind if you buy these books because they will be for my ministry. Is somebody hearing me?
Yeah.
It's only $10, by the way. It's only $10. So this one, it's more of nuggets, but I like it. I did the design of this book. Doesn't it look good?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I did the design. Why? It is called Wisdom Keys to Unlock the Gates of Marriage. 2018 and 19, when I came to this country, we have, by the way, we have universal issues when it comes to marriage. This is not for married people. Uh-uh. This is for single people.
Amen.
Can I see the singles in the house? Good. This is your book. And I think we are the majority. They are the majority. Raise your hand, I see you. Let me see all the single sisters and gentlemen. If you're 16 and above, stand up. No, probably I'm setting you up to be seen or to be found. You never know. But stand up. Hallelujah. Irene, Sister Irene, get those books here. Get those books here. Get for me now. Now. Because if I don't do this and finish, we will not do it. Pastor, allow me. Please give me the permission.
Okay.
Please kindly. So I want just every single person, if you don't have $10, tell your mama. Stella will buy for Dominique.
Yes.
Okay? So all the single people, make sure you have your copy here. This one will speak to you, Sharon. Because they say it. I keep names. I don't forget. Yes. If you are able to buy, you can buy. I'm not forcing anybody. It's whoever wants. Okay? You'll get them from Irene, okay?
Yes.
And all the grown-ups, this is your book.
Yes.
You will love it. You pick one for Mr. Monen, Mwangi. Mr.
Yes.
Mwangi, he already promised to buy. Amen?
Amen.
Are you excited in the house of the Lord?
Yes.
Are you happy?
Yes.
Haven't we had a great time?
Yes.
Praise God.
Amen.
We have been basking in the glory for the last 3 days.
Yes.
And so we are going to finish glorious in Jesus' name. Amen?
Amen.
And now I can see you a lot. Amen. Greetings from my husband, Peter Friendrich. Every day he says, please pass my love and greetings to the church. And I have a wonderful man. I have a wonderful husband. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
No regrets. He's a man of God. A powerhouse of prayer. And an apostle in business. An apostle in business. This man has traveled all West and America and Africa nations for business. But he preaches the gospel to the Indians, to the Muslims. Oh, I bless the Lord for that man. I couldn't have had a better gift. So, anyway, good to see all of you. Okay, Daniel chapter 1. You know, she's wondering how I got to...